guys, it's Tani. Welcome back to my channel. I feel like I might need to like do that. Nope.
No.
No. Look. That. I think this is alright. Okay. Hi guys, it's Tani. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm talking about things I wish I knew before going on a Kentucky trip. So there's just a few different little tips and tricks and not really any tricks. But this is just my experience with doing a Kentucky trip, and I just wanted to share with you my knowledge and things I wish I knew before going on the trip. So let's get into it. I've written down a few things so I don't forget. Okay, now the first thing that I wish I knew before going on Kentucky is that you will make friends. You will. Like, not maybe, not like you might if you're lucky. No, you will make friends. No matter if you are the popular loudmouth, like party goer, or if you are a bookworm who just hates going out and drinking, like, no matter who you are, you will make friends. So on my Kentucky trip, I feel like there was a really nice, diverse group of people. Like, I was worried I wouldn't make friends because I thought, oh, these people are very different to me. We all come from different places over the world. And I was thinking, oh, I'm looking at, like, everyone's just gonna be so different. But literally, like, I don't know what it is, but I think because everyone's traveling and in that like travel, I do have hair by the way, it's just in ponytail. But yeah, because everyone's in that kind of travel frame of mind, no one cares. Like, you just literally make friends like this to get more out of the experience. If you are, I consider myself a really shy person. Like, I'm very introverted. I like time alone, I like to just be at home, but I did push myself to get out of my comfort zone and try to make friends, and it did pay off. So I will say, like, yes, if you do put a little bit more effort in, you will make more friends, but you are bound to just fit in and click with someone straight away. Like, I wish I had known that going into it, because that was literally my biggest concern, is not making any friends. And honestly, coming back now, I am best friends with so many people I went on that trip with. So yeah, you definitely will make friends, that's for sure. Tip number two, I wish I got there a few days earlier than the trip started. So I arrived, so my Kentucky started on, I think it was this, I don't know what day, I think it was Saturday. So let's just say my trip started on the Saturday. I arrived at 1 o'clock in the afternoon that day. So the trip kind of starts with a meeting that night. I think it was at 6 o'clock. So I got to my hotel, I think maybe around 3, or I honestly have no idea. But yeah, I got there in the afternoon and just kind of had a shower and then started to meet a few of the people before we actually had our welcome meeting. I was fine that day. I wasn't tired at all, but the first, I think it might have just been the trip that I did. Like, the Greek Island Hopper is very full on and it's quite fast paced. I think most Kentuckys are fast paced, but I found that because I hadn't got there a few days earlier, I'd pretty much had like 5 hours sleep in 3 days. And then when the tour started, you've got late nights and early starts. So I felt like I wasn't making the most of my nights out because I was so exhausted from not having any sleep. So honestly, I think in the first week I had like a combined 10 hours sleep for the whole week. I was just exhausted. I would just recommend getting there a few days earlier. Not so much for jet lag. Jet lag I can cope with, but it's just so you've got energy, because you're gonna have a big couple of weeks no matter really what tour you're doing. So just make sure you are refueled after you get off the plane so you are ready to go and have some big long days. Third thing I wish I had known was to take medication for literally everything. So before I left, I was like, I hate overpacking. So I remember my mum being like, take your allergy medication, take hydrocodone flu, take this, that. And I was like, so it'll be fine. Like I'm only gone for a few weeks. Like I don't need it. But like literally people were getting sick left, right and center. Like I got headaches all the time because I was just so tired. And I think one day I was like really sick in the stomach. It was lucky that one of the girls I became friends with, she's a nurse and she literally had medication for absolutely everything under the sun. So I think the one thing you do want to overpack with is medicine, just because you don't want to miss out on like an add-on or an activity because you're not feeling well. Another thing would be to always have cash on you. Back home in Australia, I pretty much never have cash on me. I always use my card for absolutely everything. But I quickly discovered that it's much easier to have cash on you, especially when you're like just traveling in a group as well, because most of the time you'll go out for like a dinner and you'll all just like share everything, or I don't know, but normally they won't split the bills. So you want to have as much cash on you as possible, and not all like big notes. You want to have a bit of coins, like smaller notes, because you're often on a budget when you're traveling. You don't want to be like only having a $50 note and then not getting any change back. So always carry cash on you. Particularly I find in most other countries, like not Australia, everyone tips. So you always wanna make sure you've got loose change on you so you can tip and all that stuff. So always carry cash. And then another thing is that, so I took my good camera, so the one that I'm using now to record, and like I am glad I took it because I did get some good photos. However, I wouldn't have needed it. Like looking back now, I probably wouldn't have taken it, purely because I've got an iPhone 7 and it takes pretty good photos by itself. The only thing it doesn't do, like where most phones won't do, is take good photos in like at nighttime. Unless you're planning on taking like photos at nighttime or really professional shots, I wouldn't worry about taking a like proper camera, because I think my iPhone would have been enough while I was away. The last thing I wish I knew was that there is a lot of freedom on Kentucky. So I was quite concerned because I am so introverted. I thought that it would be like so full on 24/7. I was kind of under the assumption that I wouldn't have any time to myself and I would just need to be always like entertaining. It's not like that at all. I had purchased a few good books before I left, so I was like, I'll take these and hopefully I can just read by the pool a little bit. And then I was like, I bet I won't be able to read by the pool. I bet it'll be like, we'll be swimming and playing games and whatever. But like, it's not like that at all. You can do whatever you want. So the group I was kind of hanging out with, all very similar to me, and we would just go and sit by the pool, and you don't have to talk to people 24/7. You can, this sounds so stupid saying it out loud, but I think that's just me as like an anxious individual. This is the stuff that I think about. So maybe this might help someone else who is anxious, but yeah, so you don't need to be talking 24/7. I often just read by the pool. A few of the other girls would even just go, we'd all be hanging out, and then some of them would just go and have a sleep for the afternoon, and it wasn't like awkward or anything. You just understand that everyone needs their own space and own recovery. So that actually concludes today's video. I really hope this has helped at least one person with their thoughts on Kentucky or their preparations for Kentucky. Honestly, like, I cannot recommend doing Kentucky enough. It was the best thing I've ever done. If you have any other questions, like regarding Kentucky or even regarding anything, just leave a comment down below. I always reply to comments, and I always love when people comment. But yeah, I always reply to comments, so feel free to leave me a message if you have any questions, or if you have like maybe like a, I might do a Kentucky Q&A, because I've had actually a lot of questions regarding Kentucky, like how much it costs and what it's like and everything. So I might actually look into doing that. Give this video a thumbs up if you want me to do a Kentucky Q&A. Yeah, thank you so much for watching. Please remember to like and subscribe if you have enjoyed this one. And I shall see you in my next video. Bye.